Hi, it's Brian. I want to go over the loan process with you so that you'll know what to expect. First of all, before you're under contract and before you've given me the go-ahead and given me all the paperwork with the refinance, you're only going to be dealing directly with me. But after we have a contract and you've gotten your initial paperwork, your pay stubs, your W-2s, your bank statements, once I have all that, what I do is I turn it all over to my processor, and I have two processors, Jenny and Pam. So depending on what type of loan you have and, you know, who's available at the time is who you're going to end up working with. And you're going to work exclusively with that processor. What she's going to do is enter everything into the system wherever it belongs, and then they're going to review everything line item by line item. I don't go through every single deposit in your bank account and every single withdrawal, and I don't read every single number on your paperwork. You know, it's really their job to do that. So when they do that, a lot of times they anticipate the questions that the underwriter will have. So they're going to present their first list. And a lot of times on the first list, some things that you might see are going to be deposits in your bank account that aren't from your pay stub, your paycheck. So every 2 weeks, if you get $1,500 deposited in your checking account, then all of a sudden you have a $500 deposit, they're going to want to know where that money's coming from. And all the way down at the beginning, the reason why they want to know is just make sure you haven't taken out any loans that they don't know about. So just please be prepared for that. Anytime you have any deposits, you're going to have to explain them. The next thing might be an explanation letter for something, you know, why did this happen, or provide, you know, a piece of paper that I just forgot to ask for. Another thing is the terms of withdrawal for your 401k or how the thing is structured, these types of things. So after I turn everything into them, it usually takes them a day to come back with it. At the end of the day, they'll usually email me a list, and then I'll email it to you and CC them that this is your initial first list. Now, this list is probably the bigger of the list, and it's really important that you get that back quickly because we haven't submitted the loan until you get that paperwork back and it's been cleared by the processor as being acceptable. So please, please, please get that back quickly. Now, once you've gotten that back and the processor is satisfied with it, then what we do is what's called the initial submission. That's where we send it up to the underwriter. Everything at Envoy Mortgage is paperless, electronic. So all your paperwork's now been scanned, and it's all put into the appropriate queues inside the electronic loan system we use, and it's sent up. Now, the initial approval of your loan is usually 2 to 3 days. So from whatever time it gets initially submitted, it's going to be 2 to 3 business days later. Once that comes out, the underwriter will then have their own set of things that they're going to need in order to approve the loan. If it's denied, it'll just be denied, but normally we're not going to submit anything that's going to be denied, so we're assuming you're going to get approved here. So when it comes out, the underwriter is going to have what we call STIPs, stipulations. So it says, you know, approved contingent upon letter of explanation for blah, blah, blah back in 2010, whatever it is. And then, again, please get that paperwork back very quickly. Now, usually what that means is we have an exact list on what it's going to take to close your loan. So it's going to say, you know, we need to verify rent on this date. We need to verify this, that, or this. But please understand that this is it right here. Once you get that back to us, then we submit it again, and now we're talking 1 to 2 days, usually 24 hours to what they call clear STIPs. Once they clear all the STIPs, you've given them everything everything they've asked for. Now we have what's called a clear to close. Once we have the clear to close, then we start working with the title company in order to what we call approve the HUD. The HUD is the final document that describes all of the fees that you've been charged and all of the closing costs and all of the escrow accounts that have been set up and everything. So that's your final numbers. And the numbers you're really worried about are how much money do I need or how much money am I getting back and what is my payment and are all the numbers what they said they were. So please be assured by law, all the numbers I told you, they can't change. So it's either going to be what I told you or it'll be less. So don't worry about that. But so we're at the point now where the loan is clear to close. It goes back and forth between the title company and Envoy Mortgage for another day is usually what that takes. And then they do something called order the docs and order the wire. So if you're able to get your paperwork back to us within hours and not days, you know, you can see that this process could be inside of 2 weeks. assuming that the appraisal comes back on time. However, usually it's understandable that you're not able to get all this paperwork right away, or you know, things come up. That's why we give ourselves 30 days to close a loan. So once it comes out clear to close, again, we're 2 days away, usually 2 to 3 days away from actually going to settlement. And then the way it works on settlement is the title company and Envoy Mortgage go back and forth making sure that all the numbers are accurate. And usually we don't have your exact numbers on what everything's going to be until the day of settlement. It's just sort of the way the whole process works. So I need you to understand two things. First of all, I'm not going to be able to tell you how much money you're going to need to close to bring to the settlement table or how much money you're getting back until usually the day of settlement. And the other thing is, just kind of understand a little more about the process. You can see it's a little bit tricky for us to be able to set your settlement date if we're doing this sort of like rush to close thing. Now, if we have a loan and we get it on the 1st and need to settle on the 30th, that's usually like no problem at all. But if you're, you know, doing a refinance, I don't know when we're going to be able to close until we get that final clear to close from the underwriter, because chances are that second submission that we put might have had another stip, and then now we're looking at another 2 days. So just understand, we can't usually set your settlement date until we get the clear to close from the underwriter, and we're not going to know your final numbers until the final day. Other than that, you know, just please focus on getting your paperwork back, and if anything comes up in the meantime, sort of let us know, keep us aware of it. And as always, if there's any questions about anything, if there's something you're uncomfortable with there's, you know, chances there are, there's a ton of emails and a ton of numbers flying around, just call me. I'm here. This is my job, is to make you feel comfortable and set expectations. I always say, don't worry until I worry, and by the time I'm worried, it's way too late to do anything about it. So there's nothing you can do. This is Brian Mayer. I look forward again to talking to you soon. Have a great day.